probably what I said before. I think Ito will go a lot for the smashes. And I think
there
this
has
is
been a few from Japan and also from Korea, China, and so forth. So she's not intimidated.
Ooh.
Look at that. Put a lot of power there. Full of strength. Go to the middle right there.
You can use her fastness and the smash. So I think she has really a lot of powers to play against Haiying.
Rhythm again for this match. Mm-hmm. And of course, both, you know, lost in the semi.
Why? Different play than Ito.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really important that you find her own defense rhythm again.
Right. At the age of 37, there was we mentioned in our previous.
Maybe Ito forces her to attack even more, and especially the backhand. Yeah, I feel like Haiying didn't got the rhythm yet.
That's true. Rhythm that she needs to deal with. Look at that. I mean,
try to go a little bit more into the rhythm, or she have to run a little bit more. The reactions or the placement can also be a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
That Ito cannot smash too easy.
Her powerful forehand. Oh, that's too much. The difference between Chenmeng and Ito is the word speed.
Yeah, it's really the speed.
See that she doesn't.
Even though she plays early, it's also again a difficult placement.
That's why I meant she got a warning, really. But remember, in the afternoon, she got a warning like this.
Yeah, also again. And that's open a little bit more, so you can hide it less. So sometimes, if the umpires complain about this, I also go to the middle line and, okay, I serve from there.
Right. Oh.
I think, you know, like now already, I feel she got a little bit more balls. And it's good if she can receive good, then at Ito cannot start too easily.
To the other side, forehand.
I think it's also good if she can, like, defense a little bit low. Then it's more difficult to smash.
Oh. Doesn't give you a chance to rest or regroup at all.
Yeah, and you know, also with both sides, not only with the.
Right. Of course, hours ago, her first World Cup title. And then again, she's still young. Oh boy.
Oh. Really have to keep moving for the ball.
Back from Haiying.
Yes, it will be good if she can use it a little bit more.
Nice.
Again, just feel that looking very confident. There you go.
11-7.
She plays it so good, the rallies are so hard.
Mm-hmm.
So then after I tried also to use my serve.
Go to read her service with variations.
Yes, it was. Of course, her serve is one of her qualities. I think if you play a little bit more against her, then you will see it.
As you mentioned, she's been practicing very hard, ferociously, and getting some new tricks. Oh, that's a good one.
You know, Ito also have the time against choppers to really look for the placement to go there.
Well, that's good. That's good.
Game.
Mm-hmm. Well, I guess the players, right?
Yeah, to cheer up the players.
How do you feel when you have this kind of stadium without too many, you know, people or fans around? That's what we use the word, actually. We call it return. And
to make this happen.
Right. Seven apiece. Haiying is trying to mix things. Yeah.
I think.
Critical moment in game three.
Ooh, she doesn't. Ooh, Ito was moving wrong. She recovered herself now.
Mm-hmm. So game points in game three.
Oh, good flip. Also good attacking.
Ah, just too strong.
Finish the whole body, the whole movement. And then, like this. This is changing sides from Haiying as well. And again, as a chopper, you cannot afford to make the push. She feels just so confident.
Hmm. Look at that, the player.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, the way she deals with the choppers. Of course, you know, as we mentioned, she's got a.
Happy at the moment. attacking point. An attack again.
Oh, the
but I still think you have to make the variation sometimes. You cannot just chop.
Mm-hmm. Six match points. That's it.
That's it, yes.
Mima Ito really...